Everything that could have gone wrong with the Edmonton Oilers went wrong. I'm battling a cough. My throat is sore, but I'm gonna get through this commentary because we have like five different amazing lead topics that we can go off of. We can talk about, hey, firstly, Elias Pettersson, number one in the NHL in points. He got an assist in the last minute of the game. So now he's at 21 points. He overtakes Jack Hughes and Nikita Kucherov. Jack Hughes, of course, injured week to week. He's going to be out for a while. Nikita Kucherov, 4 points tonight against the Maple Leafs. So he bolted up to number one with 20. But Petey, hey, he's got his 21st. He is number one. Let's freaking go. Second topic that we can talk about. You know who else is number two in that tie with Jack Hughes and Nikita Kucherov? It's Quinn freaking Hughes. He gets himself a 4-point night today, and he's projected to number two. First and second in the NHL in points, Petey and Quinn Hughes. Dude, Quinn is out here tied with his brother for points on the year. The Athletic said that Quinn Hughes was a 3B tier defenseman, and he's like, okay, well, screw that. I'm going to put my pitch in for the heart. I'm going to give my own chance to win the Art Ross this year and project myself to number two in NHL points by the start of November. How in the world is that possible? That's storyline number two. You know what storyline number three is? The fact that the goaltending discrepancy in Vancouver versus Edmonton on November 6, 2023 was so vast that you had Thatcher Demko robbing guys left, right, and center. In the first period, it was all Demko, 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 and then it's Stuart Skinner that absolutely craps the bed. He gives the Oilers fans nothing to cheer for after the Oilers had all the momentum, all the shots, all the grade A opportunities. The Canucks bounce back, and like that, Stuart Skinner allows 3 straight goals. Goaltender controversy in this game was rampant. And then you could even talk more so about other Oilers things. Connor McDavid, Leon Draisaitl, cry, McDavid, cry. These guys look like they have just given up. They can't score points in this one. They have a really hard time doing so. McDavid, held on to by Ian Cole and JT Miller the entire game, they shut him down. So what does Connor McDavid do? He gets all pissy. He starts taking unnecessary penalties. You had Leon Draisaitl take a game misconduct. And the Oilers superstars, the guys who are supposed to lead this team, they start crumbling away. Even some of the other top paid players on this team, Darnell Nurse taking penalties where he's ripping the helmets off of guys. Terrible defensive plays by guys like Evan Bouchard. You have other just boneheaded plays from this Oilers team that showcase why they're more bust than they are cup. Cup or bust? Yeah, no, you're leaning towards the bust, baby. And the final storyline that we could also talk about and nail home in this video is Jay Woodcroft. You know how we said Draisaitl got a 10-minute misconduct? McDavid went out there, took some bad penalties. He was getting angry. He was getting pissy. This Oilers squad, just terrible mentality towards the end. Jay Woodcroft got in on the action too. And he got ejected from this game. Like, when was the last time you saw that? An NHL head coach get ejected from a game because he's chirping at the referees. He didn't even stick around for the call. He didn't contest it or whatever. The play stopped. The referee pointed at Jay Woodcroft and he just left the game. He yeeted. He was gone. Is this the last game that Jay Woodcroft is going to coach for the Edmonton Oilers? They play off against the San Jose Sharks on Thursday, and that is going to be maybe as much of a make or break a game as you can get, aside from this one. Because the Vancouver Canucks, and we haven't said this at all in the video actually, the Vancouver Canucks defeated the Oilers 6-2 in what was one of the craziest games we could ever think of in terms of conversations. As we said, there's like 5 main topics that we could individually make videos about with this one game, but I'm gonna try to condense it all in one video here because my voice is hurting a ton and I'm just getting through it with sheer raw passion and determination, baby. So, as we had said, the first, like, 15 minutes of this game were all just Edmonton, 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 Edmonton. So many shots, so many grade A opportunities on Thatcher Demko. He made so many incredible gosh darn saves in this first period. The Oilers had momentum. It was like 7-0, the shots on goal in the first 3 minutes of the game. The first goal of the game, it's Sam Gagner down low who ends up chipping the puck in front of the goal, and Mattias Ekholm walks in and just blasts it into the back of the net. 1-0 game, about 7 minutes in, give it a little bit, and eventually the shots find themselves up to like 18-2 Edmonton at the halfway point. It was really bad. Like, Stuart Skinner was cold. Demko was making all the saves. That is, until, with 8:30 to go in the first, you had Quinn Hughes toss it towards the goal, and it goes in off of Vinny Desharnais. Hughes was trying to center it back door for Michkov, but nah, Huggy Bear gets himself a goal in this one to kick things off for Vancouver, and that's not even it, because the Canucks score on their very next shot. Dakota Joshua centering pass to Pius Suter, who comes right in and blasts it by Skinner. It doesn't look like a good goal. Like, he was in the middle of the net right there. How does that go in? Such a clean shot, such a clean look, and Skinner looks terrible on that play. Immediately after this play, you had Darnell Nurse go to the box for cross-checking, and the Canucks score again! Hughes over to Miller, the shot blocked, and Boeser on the rebound tucks it in 3-1. That is the seventh shot of the game for the Vancouver Canucks, and they're up 3-1 on an Oilers team that was just pounding with shots on Thatcher Demko. They could not be stopped for the first, like, 15 minutes or so. Everything, and I say everything because pretty much everything, went to crap after that. The second period starts out. There are a few penalties back and forth. Mattias Ekholm took an interference penalty at the end of the first. Hoglander had interference in the second. But the first goal in the second actually comes from the Oilers. It's a weird play where Thatcher Demko is behind his own net and he gets taken down, he gets tripped, and the Oilers eventually scored. I mean, Draisaitl ends up getting that one on the board, but Demko was completely removed from the play. You could say it wasn't goalie interference because he was behind the net, which I guess is fair, but that was definitely not the goal you wanted to see. It's a 3-2 game now. Oilers bring it within one, but the Canucks score a little bit after that because it's Sam Lafferty who comes in on a 2-on-1 rush. He takes a shot. The rebound is out there for Hoglander, and he is able to bury it up high on Stuart Skinner, making it 4-2. So there you go. Adversity battled here in Vancouver. You give up a bad goal, you score one, you take it back with style. Hoglander, Lafferty, great on them for getting on the board. And the third period is where everything completely falls apart for the Oilers because they score 1 minute into the third. The puck is tossed out in front, Demko makes the save, there's a big scrum on the ensuing rebound, and eventually it finds itself in the back of the net, and they deem it a kicking motion goal. Warren Fogle kicks the puck into the goal, and if you look at the video replay, the puck was going in anyway. Like, it took enough bounces and rubbed enough people that it was gonna go in the net, but Warren Fogle kicks what was probably gonna be a good goal, making it not a good goal. So there you go, should have been 4-3. Nah, it's not 4-3, goal disallowed, it's still 4-2 Vancouver, and this is where everything goes bad. Connor McDavid didn't get any points in this one because Ian Cole and JT Miller were on him the entire game. Miller was pissing off McDavid with a little bit of a shove after a play. Miller and Hyman got into a scuff, it was 4-on-4 after, and then Connor McDavid on the ensuing play takes a terrible, egregious penalty on Pius Suter by cross-checking the guy, and he is just whining on his way back to the penalty box. He's arguing with the referees. Leon Draisaitl also had a 10-minute misconduct in there. Just so much going on here for the Oilers. Miller eventually scored a goal that didn't look like a goal at first, but upon video review it was. It's a long shot and it goes in. There you go, Miller assisted by Hughes and Hronek. He then had Anthony Bevilier take a penalty for tripping Evander Kane, but that was quickly negated because Jay Woodcroft got tossed. He gets ejected after mouthing off to the refs. It's 4-on-4. Everything gets killed. McDavid and Draisaitl don't end up playing towards the end. It appears that they're getting saved for San Jose. Either that or they just got straight up benched. And then the Vancouver Canucks end up scoring yet another goal at the end after Darnell Nurse takes a penalty.
It's Quinn Hughes to Elias Pettersson, right out in front of Brock Boeser. Beautiful tic-tac-toe cross-crease play, open net. Boeser makes no mistake. Petey with the assist, putting him at 21 points. Quinn Hughes with the assist, putting him at 20 points. Elias Pettersson and Quinn Hughes are 1-2 in the NHL in points, baby. And who would have thought that was possible, especially in a crazy game like this, where everything went wrong for the Edmonton Oilers. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below about this game. Vancouver wins 6-2. I hope you enjoyed this video. 99. And bye.